Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Stephanie Stevens Show. Thank you guys so much for tuning to my channel, and thank you guys for supporting me through my journey. Today on my show, I have the incredible Mr. Joey Joseph, an incredible Liza Minelli performer. He has traveled all over the world, and he is an actor, and he is a true pioneer in the world of female impersonation, and really celebrity female impersonation, such as Liza Minnelli, Connie Francis, and countless others. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like for you guys to just welcome to my show today, Mr. Joey Joseph. How you doing, lady?
Hi, Stephanie. It's so nice to be here. You said pioneer, and I felt a hip go out of place.
Oh.
Don't skip pioneer. I just saw myself with the axe and everything. Yeah, but thank you.
You're welcome. Where are you living now?
South Philly, born and raised.
Okay, so how is the business in South Philly for you? How is the business?
I work in Atlantic City. How's that?
That's amazing. Amazing.
At the Tropicana, yes, Divas Royale. It's good. We have Bob and Barbara's here. Mm-hmm. And we have Brittany Lynn's Drag Mafia. She's a pioneer in her own right. She works tirelessly for the LGBTQ. She got the first gay string band with Queens in the parade, the Mummers Parade.
Oh, that's amazing. Now,
the Philadelphia is coming up. Yes.
Well, I hear Philadelphia has a slogan. Is it the something of love? The
city brotherly of love. Yes. Brotherly love. So it's the city of brotherly and sisterly love now.
Okay. Now, how long have you been doing Liza?
Since I want to say around 93. I started out with Connie Francis. Okay. In 1987, because a wonderful entertainer, Nikki Starr, she's no longer with us. She came up to me. She saw me dressed for Halloween, and she said, "You got to get on stage." I'm like, "No, I can never go on stage." "No, no, please." She's for 45 minutes. She tried to convince me, but she said, "You look like this country singer." So my partner at the time were like, Loretta Lynn, we're called Patsy Cline. So he said, "Do you mean Connie Francis?" And she said, "Yes, that's what he said." "Well, she's Italian." I said, "Oh, I can never look like her. She's gorgeous, blah, blah, blah." So that led to I did Connie first, so it was more comfortable. It led to Judy Garland. It led to Marilyn Monroe. It led to Bette Midler. And then finally, Liza Minnelli.
Okay. I see that you met Connie Francis in person. Yes. And she wrote about you in her book.
Yes.
Okay. Can you tell us a little bit? Tell us a little bit how that happened.
Well, I keep regular contact with Connie. She's a wonderful person. She's very down to earth. In fact, she personally gave me permission to use her songs that she owns. So she had contacted me through email. And she said, "Send her all these pictures." She was working on her book. So I got all these pictures scanned and I sent whatever I had. And I said, "Well, if she does it, she does it. I know how things get edited and cut." Well, everybody kept a secret. So the book came out and I didn't get a chance to see it. A good friend of mine called me and he says, "I got the book." And he says, "You're not going to believe you're in the book." I said, "Stop breaking them for me. You know, you can tell how South Philly I am. So don't break them for me." So he took a picture of it and he sent it to me. Oh my God. So I thanked her. I did.
Wonderful. Now, have you ever met Liza?
I saw Liza 3 times, and she doesn't see people afterwards. Connie does, but Liza now.
Now, what do you say about, you know, we know Liza is a great live performer. She's mainly when her career was earlier on, she was fantastic.
Yes.
And I mean, we're not taking no credibility from her, but what do you think about the issues of the drinking?
How do you
Liza with drinking too much?
Well, you know, my grandmother gave me some good advice. If it isn't my ass, don't worry about it. Let her live. It's her life, right?
Mm. So now, as you know, Liza is a gay icon. A lot of queens and performers impersonate Liza.
Bill Craig is one of the best, yes.
Mm-hmm. Why is it that you perform Liza? What is it about Liza as an impersonation that has attracted you?
Her charisma and mm-hmm. her charismatic way of performing. Mm-hmm. I had to do something to, you know, reinvent myself. Her mm-hmm. flair and her style and all that, the je ne sais quoi and all that kind of stuff. She's fabulous. So I was able to compete with the queens that do Jennifer Holliday and mm-hmm. all that spazzy stuff. I said, mm-hmm. Judy does her own, but it's very soft to where Liza's very direct. And I said, well, that's my next character. And I watched her mm-hmm. and I saw her, like I said, three times in concert. And, you know, when I go to a concert, I'm just focused and my brain, I'm lucky, is able to like pick up certain things and then mm-hmm. I can come home and I can impersonate them.
Well, you know, all my years of impersonating as many people as I do, I really admire people who look naturally like the person. This is why I chose you.
Thank you.
Because I thought you naturally look like Liza, look, even today.
They say that, yeah. They say that. I'm flattered.
And that's what I like, because that is true art. That is art. When you
can I tell you a quick funny story?
Mm-hmm.
I performed in Wilton Manor at Monkey Business. And I went there to perform as Connie, Judy, and Liza.
Mm-hmm.
Two legendary queens performers from the Copa out there mm-hmm. had to come see me because they thought I was using Connie's publicity pictures and they want to see me in person just to see if it was really, you know, was really my picture or was I using Connie's. I never had to use any celebrity that I impersonates photos. They're all my own.
Mm-hmm.
And as you can see, they're not really touched up that much. I mean, we all do a little tweaking here and there to look our mm-hmm. best, you know?
Well, I'm about to have something done, so I can't say anything. But that is what I like the most about you, because I'm sitting here, and it's like I'm looking at Liza.
Thank you.
I'm talking to Liza. And that is an amazing thing, when we can impersonate someone, and people don't have to second guess.
And this is 10 minutes of the makeup because I want to be on time.
Oh, don't tell them that, because then they'll be trying to steal the secrets.
There's no secret. I worked in New York. My dressing room was a hallway. If mm-hmm. you didn't paint fast and get against the wall until it was your turn to go on stage, you were hit by a waiter. So you had to paint and flatten yourself.
So, you know, it's funny you say that. You know that most of us impersonators have always had the roughest time with trying to just make our way. And how did you find your footing? How did you find a space for you on the stage when there's so many other Liza impersonators? What did you do to jump in front, to get on the stage, to be seen, to be in the limelight? What did you do?
I had to fight 10 years of stage fright. Mm-hmm. Some points my ex had to push me on stage, literally, because I was frozen in the wings, and he okay. gave me some good advice. If you can't stand the heat, get the blank blank out of the kitchen. So from then, I just did it. You know, I don't want to say it's talent, it's good, strong nerve to say, I can do this. Mm-hmm. And I'm a nice person, so when people meet me, it's just what you see here. I'm not fake. So I guess talent and being real with people.
Mm-hmm. Now, you know, I've worked with some of the best celebrity Liza impersonators, from Phil Craig to Joe Poza.
I love him. Yes, Joe Poza. Yes. We worked together too. Yes.
To lots of them. And it's funny how I watch, they do these things and the moves with such ease. And then when I watch you, you just do it with the same ease, but it's just natural. And that's what I like the most. Now, what have you found to be the most difficult in your career? What is difficult? I mean, we know it's hard to find work. We know that. But what is the most difficult thing you had to overcome trying to impersonate the stars? Something that to say, you know, you needed to do to get where you needed to go.
Politics. A lot of times it is politics. Who knows who you know, and you know the rest of the saying. Mm-hmm. I was not going to bend. Mm-hmm. I worked hard. I'm very proud of the things I've done. Mm-hmm. I would have liked to have been a little bit more of a success at what I do, but nobody held me back but me. Mm-hmm. So I'm strong.
Okay.
But I don't think I ever really challenged myself. I never really, really had a hard time with performing once my foot was in the door.
Okay. Now, do you find that there's competition with what you do as Liza in Philly? Because I think Craig lives in Philly.
Craig. I don't know where Craig lives. I'm not sure. I'm not sure if he's back in Vegas. But, Phil and I are great friends. I would give up the stage.
He's a nice guy. When I was trying to do Diana Ross, he helped me.
Wonderful.
I didn't look a thing like Diana Ross, but he was trying to help me do the makeup.
He is incredible. And if I were booked with him, I would never go up against him. I'm secure about all and confident of all my characters, including mm-hmm. Liza. But Phil Craig is Liza Minnelli. So I would walk aside. I would do Judy or somebody. So, yeah.
So, when you got the acknowledgement that you were going to actually be in Connie France's book, I just want to go back to that for 1 minute. Did she sign your book or did she send you a copy of it?
No.
No?
I bought my copy.
Oh, you bought your copy.
And I could have it signed. I forgot mm-hmm. to bring it when I saw her in Wildwood. I was just like so nervous. I still get thummy and tongue when I meet Connie, and I've known her personally since like 91 mm-hmm. and I still around her I'm just in awe of the woman, so it's tongue Miss Francis.
Now you said that you were acting in an off-Broadway
No. I was off-Broadway as Connie Francis in the show. I acted in an underground soap opera that was filmed here in Philadelphia called Maple Peach USA. Okay. And I played a character that escaped from a mental institution.
I'm not going to laugh, girl. That was very funny the way you said it.
The reason why I got the part is because I could laugh like Woody Woodpecker.
Oh.
There was no interview. They just said, you got the part, and that was it. And the basis of the story was I found that I was adopted, and I was rich, and I shot my grandmother. They put me in an institution, and the opening scene was me in a straitjacket. Mm-hmm. It was filmed up in West Philly, at a friend's house. And cameras came in after I beat the doctor over the head and drove off to escape. We filmed at Lancome Hospital.
Okay.
And I was in a short baby doll nightgown with pink scuffies, and I had a wig and a fall, and the wig blew off with the wind and hit a tree. But the opening scene is, you know, they film it out of context, and, you know, they film me in the straitjacket and with a gag in my mouth. And I didn't see it when they showed it, but a few people said they hit the floor. They were laughing so hard when they saw the gag in my mouth and the straitjacket.
Now, when you were, the business that we do is up and down all the time. Yeah. Now, I'm sure you have heard. I'm trying to get an interview with Frank Marino. I'm trying to. Now, what do you think has happened to places like Divas and Evening at Le Cage, the Jewel Box Review, these shows that were very prevalent for celebrity impersonators and professional ones that got paid top dollar. What do you think has happened since this business has sort of, even though it's still there, it's not as much in the mainstream as you think it should have? Because celebrity impersonation should have evolved into something much bigger, because we've been working at it for so hard for so long.
Absolutely. Well, we're all closed down. I'm out of work too because of the quarantine with the coronavirus. Mm-hmm. I've never been to Vegas to see these shows as an adult. You know, I was in Vegas as a child, I don't remember, but I don't really know. I know Frank Marino is a wonderful person. We have spoke on Facebook Messenger. He's a wonderful guy. Other than that, I don't know anything else, but I do agree with you. We should be more mainstream. It should be advertised, you know, Frank Marino or in Vegas, come see, as much as Celine Dion or Cher. Mm-hmm. Well, I shouldn't put Cher, she's a goddess. But, you know, we have paved a lot of roads for a lot of people. And people mm-hmm. do, you know, when you're good at what you do, you should get acknowledgement for it. Absolutely.
Well, you know, I had a young queen in Your Cameraman Is Shaking. Mm-hmm. I had a young queen explain to me that she thinks that celebrity impersonation is dying. And I explained to her, I don't think so. Because I explained to her, as long as older people love the divas and play their music, and as long as the young children who are rapping and doing whatever else sample their music, we will always be working. Because people can relate to that. Now, I find today that the young children don't impersonate the stars that they admire. They just prance around in multicolor, you know, in these multicolored wigs and these mm-hmm. things that, for me, a lot of the drag doesn't make sense. Mm-hmm. Celebrity impersonation makes sense. What mm-hmm. do you think about the children in your community that are probably getting top billing over you?
Well, I'm not bitter about it. I had my day when I was their age. You know, it's their mm-hmm. turn. I work with a very talented entertainer, Kelly Couture, and she'll wear different color wigs, but she came out as Gwen Stefani, and she nailed her. She looked mm-hmm. just like me. She looked just like Gwen. It was fabulous. So, a lot of the new kids are able to pull it off. And the ones that don't want to do a specific diva and just want to be them, more power to them. Because, mm-hmm. you know, like I said, I had my day when I was 20 and 21 and when I started. So I'm happy for them. I enjoy doing what I'm doing and mm-hmm. enjoy what they do.
So do you think, because I've been watching certain places like Hamburger Mary's, they're doing very well, which to me is just a little bit of an upscale of a Lacage, but the basic same format. Mm-hmm. Same thing with Lips, but it just featuring more of the trans community in a diverse kind of a way. Now, what do you think the impersonators like us, the older ones that are still around that can still do it, where do you think we fit in? What do you think we should do to get back on, get our headlines back? What do you think we should do?
Keep on doing what we do. I like to keep it real. Hopefully I'm respected by my younger drag nieces. Mm-hmm. I don't walk in with a diva attitude. When I walk in, there's no challenging each other for dominancy. When I come in, I'm a guest. I'm just like this. Mm-hmm. I can't speak for every other diva in my generation, but as for me, I think I'm where I am. Mm-hmm. I've fought all my life, and I'm going to probably continue until I retire. That's just the way it is.
Okay. What advice would you give the young children today about what we do? and what we have done.
The girls already in the business or girls that want to start in the business?
The young up and coming ones that are trying to make their way, even some of the ones that are just their first time now, either dressing in drag or trying to be a certain, trying to be female impersonators in a way, you know, understand what I mean.
Right. Well, I don't offer advice because I don't like taking advice. What I do is if they come to me, then I'll probably do what, you know, Phil Craig did to you, tweak, do a little this, soften this up, you know, if they ask for my advice, because some of the new girls already have it together and they don't want to hear from me.
Okay.
I take makeup advice from them to do eyes and everything. A lot of them are really like gorgeous with their eye makeup. And there's some divas too who put on a wig for the first time and then they'll just stroll into a dressing room. And then I'll have to be like, you know, and say, all right, honey, calm down now. We're all in this together to entertain. It's all fine. You're among friends.
So let's just say you're in the room and you're the oldest one in the room.
It happens.
A lot of us have been, a lot of times, being the older one in the room. How do you think the young children respect us in any sense?
Some of them do, and some of them don't. Now that you bring this up, of course, you know, I did a show, I'm not going to say where with whom, but the queen was very... I don't know how to say it. She was being disrespectful. Mm-hmm. And my husband, who's working the camera, also noticed it. And it was just, she's being like a little catty. And I'm a professional, okay? Mm-hmm. I'm a secure gay man that performs as a woman. Okay. And I'm secure as an entertainer. Okay. So that comes off very insecure to me. Mm-hmm. So I'll ignore it because I'm there to entertain, make my coins, and then, you know, leave.
Okay.
And she was just being a little snippy and little, and I finally just, I don't remember what I said, but I just said like, in a nice way, you know, girl, it's okay. We're all in here. We're all going to perform and do a great job. Mm-hmm. It may not have been in those kind of words, and it wasn't anything, you know, forceful or direct, or it just very nicely, like, you know, it's okay, girl. You know, mm-hmm. I'm old. But I'm not,
In your community, have you found that you are working more or less?
Well, with getting hired in Atlantic City, I'm actually working more. It's really nice.
Okay.
You know, I hope to continue after this, you know, pandemic is over with, because I enjoy working. I do enjoy working. I do.
Well, you know, I see that they're trying to get things back going in Atlantic City. I know that the boardwalk was closed for a long time.
Casinos, too, are closed, yeah. Uh-huh.
So hopefully they'll get that back going. Now, what are you doing now, like to prepare to go back to work? What's actually happening now?
I chained the refrigerator locked. Now it's chained cold. I'm on a strict diet to slim down. Okay. Thinner than I was before, so I can do my high kicks and twirls as Liza without needing oxygen afterwards.
No. I don't know what it is about you. I say this to a lot of the performers, but I am just drawn to people that are naturally talented and that just naturally have that thing. I don't know what it is, but I like it because when I'm talking to you, I feel at ease. I feel like I'm talking to Liza. I mean, it's
everybody that comes into our home says the same thing you are. I cook, I'm Italian, I cook. Mm-hmm. They feel at ease, they could sit down. And I'm a very naturally funny person. If you don't wear, you know, if you don't wear diapers, you better, because when you come to my house, if you have any bladder issues, you'll laugh till you pee. And that's true.
Now, what do you, you know, for us as older people, most of us are sort of established. I'm established. I have a house. I have my own place and all that, and I own it, and I'm okay. But there were times back in the day when we were just kikiing a little bit too much, and carrying on, being the young people that we were. Now, what have you learned? What was the most valuable lesson that you learned later on in life that you probably shouldn't have been doing when you were younger that got you where you are now?
Well, I'm always learning. Life is an experience where you always learn each day. I think I want to hold myself back. I was very insecure. I held myself back. And if I could do it differently, I probably would have been more ballsy about certain things with my life as well as my career.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know, I must say, I'm going to take my hat off to you because I find that you're naturally talented.
Thank you so much.
And that is what I was attracted to when we were going over the dip, because lots of people sent us in their story. And Perry, he's on. He's just listening to us. He's one of the directors for my show. And he said, why don't you use Joey, because he looks natural, he performs natural, and that's what we want. And we didn't want that, the talk show, we didn't want that catty, how do I say, that
gay. Oh, I know what you mean. Yes.
We didn't want that for the show. We want it to be, we want people to be educated and inspired by the show. And for me, you do that. So I just
want to- You just have to be yourself. You know, just be yourself. Don't put on airs. I know a lot of girls, some do these fake bios. I come from South Philly, the streets of South Philly, from an Italian family in South Philly. I would never change that on my bio. I'm very, very proud of my heritage.
Okay. So tell the audience what's your name and how we can get in contact with you. If they want to book you.
Oh, well, they can go to my email. It's Joey Josephs. And the email is joeyjosephs87, because that's the year I started, at gmail.com.
Okay.
Facebook. I just did a fan page, you know, because I'm going to stop using the general one because I get too many messages that I don't really like. I'm happily married and I'm not, you know, I'm not a real woman, and some of the pictures that are sent are not really in good taste.
Oh, okay. We understand. Like I said, I know you're going to do a little number for us now, right? So I want to just say, I take my hat off to you, Joey.
To you as well.
I've watched your career, like I said, to many of them. I study before I speak. So I just want to say thank you so much. You're a great inspiration into the world of celebrity impersonations, and you do a fantastic job as Liza. And I can relate to this.
Thank you so much. A lot of pressure on my shoulders now. I hope I can, don't break a heel.
Oh, okay.
That's happened too on stage.
Yeah. So can we get a little number from you?
Yes, you can, honey. You want to start it? You want me to hold this?
I'm going to talk while you get ready.
Sure. And I'm going to hold the camera while
you drink it. Thank you guys so much for tuning in.
You edit? Do you edit this?
We're going to have Mr. Joey Joseph perform in just a minute here as Miss Liza Minelli for you guys right here on the Stephanie Stevens Show. He's born and raised in South Philly. I am here in downtown Toronto, and we are doing this show to just say welcome to our world of celebrity impersonations. Something that he does very well is Miss Liza Minelli. So ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the stage, Mr. Joey Joseph as Liza Minelli.
Yeah.
Bravo, bravo. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Joey, for being on the Stephanie Stevens Show.
Thank you, Stephanie, for having me.
It was great meeting you. Thank you so much. You're a fantastic performer, and I look forward to working with you one day.
Hopefully. Bring me to Toronto.
we're going to try to do something. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
We'll chat soon. Have a great week.
You too.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.